racing may have been cancelled for today, but it's business as usual for Steve Parrish. Steve, first of all, I can't not ask about the attire. Please enlighten me.
Well, I know you want one of these, as do so many other people, but it was raining a minute ago, and I know it's not raining now, but I'm just being prepared. I was sort of a bit of a Boy Scout, and it's just my little waterproof outfit. It was when I was a bit younger and a bit thinner.
Very nice. Now, obviously we said business as usual for you today. You've still got a lot of filming commitments. Just talk to me about what you're doing at the moment.
Well, sadly today, not so much as we'd like to be doing. The whole programme is just an hour-long show that goes out on ITV4 on Thursday evening. I think it's 9 o'clock. And it's a package that's all about the events that take place here at the Classic TT. Not so much about the racing, because we don't have all the cameras around the course, but it's about the fun that goes on in the paddock here, the kind of sundown movie show that takes place, Derby, of course, and just the action that takes place here. And there's so much to do. So it's very much about that. But today, clearly, we've had our wings clipped, because we were expecting to be up on the start line about now with the junior race, and then it was going to be the wonderful Honda 6 going around, and then it was going to be the superbike race, and then, more importantly, it was going to be me in the parade.
Because now, you were going to ride a really special bike. Just tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, my real kind of time in Grand Prix was riding RG500 Suzukis. And there's a lovely gentleman here called Steve Wheatman, who has a huge collection of Suzukis, ranging all the way through from even before my time right up to more modern bikes. He owns the bike that Michael Dunlop would be riding today or tomorrow. So an RG500 in Texaco Heron Suzuki colours when I was teammates to Barry Sheen, and he's got one of those bikes here, and I've got my number on it ready to ride in the parade when it happens. And it looks like I'm going to miss it now, because I've got to go home tomorrow.
It must be amazing though, being here and reliving when you were racing, you know, and all your old sort of teammates, or you know, people that you were in teams with, you know, all the mechanics from that era, all over here celebrating the Classic TT.
It is, it's great. And truthfully, if I had to choose, if someone said I could only come to one of the TTs, I'd come to this one, because I love the smell and the noise and the bikes. And as you rightly say, all my old mates that used to race with me. Sadly now, instead of talking about fuel jetting and gearbox sprockets, we're talking about what tablets do you take and what ointment do you put on your bad knees and things like that. So, but it's fun. And, you know, the older you get, the faster you were, is the kind of saying what we say. And we reminisce a great deal. And then hearing all the bikes and seeing all those lovely bikes going around. And the best part is they're being ridden by current TT riders that really know how to ride them properly. And the lap records just keep falling and things like that. But no, I think it's an absolute ball. And I'm really disappointed that it looks like I won't get to do another lap here at the Classic. But I'm sure I'll be able to find one at the TT next year. Yeah, really enjoying it. And just a little plug for myself, I have the theatre show called The Mad Tour that I travel around the country we're doing, and we've just sorted out that we'll be at the Gaiety on Mad Sunday next year for the TT, so the show will be back here. We did it 4 years ago and it was very successful, so I'm back doing that.
Looking forward to that one. Final question, there should have been two Classic TT races today. Who is your money on for tomorrow?
Well, originally for the superbike race I got it on Bruce Anstey. But then Michael Dunlop, who'd had so many problems with his bike, they finally got it sorted out, and he borrowed Lee Johnston's bike and went probably faster than Bruce. So am I allowed to say one of them too? Actually, I'm going to say Bruce Anstey, because I'd like to see that old 500 two-stroke bike win it, and Bruce Anstey's a lovely bloke, so I'm going to go for him, but it's going to be a close race. And of course, the junior race, I think that's very, very open, and it's really whose bike keeps going, because they're kind of stretched a little bit. So I'm really not sure about that race. I'm going to probably say Dean Harrison for the junior race. So, but whatever, it'll be great racing, and the noise and the smell is just, it's utopia for me.